Hey guys, David with Industry Athletics, coming to you to talk about part two of the Devil's Press. So, in part one of this video series, we talked about the Devil's Press itself, how to complete a Devil's Press, what you need to do, and some basic tips. In this video, we're gonna start to break down the Devil's Press into its component parts so that you get the most mechanical advantage and you make the movement as efficient as possible. Remember, this is for the completion of a Devil's Press. So if you've gotta do 50 Devil's Press, this is how to do it as efficiently as possible, not as difficult as possible per rep for all those trolls out there. So, just wanted to point that out. Now, in video number one, we talked about the burpee on a Devil's Press. We talked about dumbbell placement. I don't want to get too much into that. I want to start to talk about the press portion of the movement. So, just for review, when I jump down, I want to make sure that there's enough room to touch my chest to the ground. Then when I hop up, I've got those feet behind the dumbbell. This is where we can start to create mechanical advantage. So, where I place my hands on the dumbbells is very important. If I grab the back side of the dumbbell, so if you go down and look at my hand, I'm grabbing the back side of the dumbbell as close to the head as my legs. This is gonna create a poor position during my press. If I'm here, I now try to drive that dumbbell up, that weight is in front of my frontal plane. If you know anything about weightlifting, you wanna keep that weight as close to your frontal plane as possible. Nothing changes about moving a dumbbell as opposed to a barbell. So, instead of grabbing the back side of the dumbbells, I wanna grab the weight as close to the front of the head as possible. That's gonna allow me to then drive the weight up. The dumbbell is gonna be behind my hand and keep it close to my body. I wanna use that mechanical advantage to my favor. Now, when that swing pulls me back into that natural hinge position, my hands are gonna come in contact with my inner thigh. So I wanna make sure that I feel that forearm contact with my leg. That's gonna allow me to efficiently transfer the energy from the hip drive into the kettlebell, or the dumbbells, excuse me. So as I drive my hips, my arms are in contact with my legs, it gets that additional energy, and I get to that triple extension, just like if I was lifting a barbell. Then, instead of allowing those hands to come out straight, in what we would do is for a kettlebell swing, this is just like a snatch or a dumbbell snatch. I'm gonna drive my hips, I'm gonna get to triple extension, and I'm gonna start pulling my elbows high and outside, and then pressing the dumbbells overhead or dropping underneath, catching and standing. So I wanna show this in slow motion so you guys get a hint of that elbow pull and press in that double dumbbell snatch. So I'm here, I pull those dumbbells back. Keeping that dumbbell as close to my body as possible is gonna get exponentially more important as the weight of the dumbbell gets heavier. So if you're trying to do 50s as opposed to 35s, keep that dumbbell close. Same thing for 70s or anything heavier than that. So I wanna get some Devil's Press. Get those dumbbells set up. Grab the front of the dumbbell, drop it down, chest to the ground, legs up behind the dumbbells. Drive, pull, and press. Keep those dumbbells close. Good hip extension. Drive and press. Keep the dumbbells close. Efficient movement, mechanical advantage. Guys, good luck.